who was, who is, and who is to come. Sun TV, if the sun sets you free, you shall be free indeed.
People who have done wrong to me, people who I want to forgive, and people who I want to help, or like, it just, when I pray, the name just pops out in my mind, and it's like Jesus just giving me the name so that I need to do something to get more stronger in relationship with them.
The Sun TV.
He sent his only son, Jesus Christ, for us, and Jesus Christ suffered for us. He loved us so much, and for our sake, he sacrificed his own life.
The Sun TV.
Hi, good morning. So I'm standing in front of Holy Ghost Church today. And since we're in the Lenten season, I wanted to talk to a few people from the parish, basically.
Instead of listening to music or talk radio in my car, I decided that time for prayer and listen to God. The best part is, at the first, it was a difficult transition. The silence was deafening. But soon, I started enjoying the quiet time. I started praying for people who required my prayer. I started praying for my family and myself.
I took time every day to draw in a sketchbook, and I call this time my God time. I wanted to make each day of Lent special by taking time to reflect on God and my relationship with God.
The Sun TV.
Hello guys, I'm in St. Joseph College, so I have few students here, so I'm going to interview them about Lent. So let's ask what they feel about Lent. So I have a guy here, so what's your name?
My name is Webin.
Okay, Webin, so what's your views about Lent? What do you feel about Lent?
Lent is basically for 40 days that Jesus was struggling, so for Lent, I read Bibles every day.
Lynn, these 40 days are the days where, as a Christian, there are different denominations, but as a Christian, that is the time where you purify yourself spiritually, and moreover, you make this connection the bond with God. Like, you know, you try to make it more stronger. Like a car giving a service to the garage. It's a time.
Yeah.
That's what I feel as a Lynn.
I believe Lynn should be something personal, that everyone should, you know, have their own routine for Lent. And basically, even though, you know, I'm not following Lent exactly to be sure, but, you know, but in my heart I have a preparation going on for Lent. So I believe each one should have a plan for their Lent and get closer to God, as this is the best time to get closer to God.
It's Balraj signing off from Sun TV. If the sun sets you free, you are free indeed.
The Sun TV.
Lent is one of the most auspicious seasons of the year for us, because that is a season where we are reminded, or we commemorate the sacrifices Jesus has made for the entire human race. So a time for abstinence from worldly pleasures, a time to stay close to Jesus.
The Sun TV.
Kind of make 40 plus tasks, and then I put them on slips of paper, and then I put them in a jar and toss them. So every morning of Lent, I pick up one slip and see what's written there. So that kind, it teaches me to it kind of also teaches me for a variety, to do things different, and basically give alms and do something good to others. Then also, like, for me it's a surprise, because every day there's something new comes in and I get to do something new good for others.
The Sun TV.
The kingdom of God about it's not about talking, gossip, drinking, eating and all kind of stuff. It's all about experiencing the Holy Spirit. That's what I practice during the Lent.
What is Lent according to you? I want some dynamic answers from you youngsters now. So, Vinod,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, Vinod, your view on Lent.
Actually, I'm a professional dancer.
Okay.
So I usually dance for movie songs and all. During this season, I usually dance for devotional songs to praise God and glorify His name.
Lent is a holy season and I mostly involve to God, draw close to God by fasting, prayers.
If a person could give his life for our sins, why can't we spend our time in glorifying his name?
I stopped spending too much of time on social media and I started spending more time with God, and I started reading Bible every day and praying every day.
Yeah, that is what our youngsters do, social media, WhatsApp, Facebook. But you see changes in them. They've sacrificed that for our Lord.